Hi, welcome to Practice with Kride. Today's focus is going to be on the Blues for Alice set of changes for alto. I'm really good at blues and F sharp and C sharp and B and E and A, because those are keys I play in a whole lot with the blues band and the funk band and the pop band. But yesterday I played a jam session. I played a fast set of Blues for Alice changes. I go, oh my God, I got to work on that stuff. So what I'm going to do is initially just walk through the pattern, and I'm not going to put a metronome to it at the beginning. My goal is to play all the chord tones so I get them familiar under my fingers. Then I'll start doing patterns to try and make it easier. So here's Blues for Alice changes for alto. It's concert F, and on alto it's a D major 7, your first chord. So then the next 2-5. That's a C half diminished, C sharp half diminished 7th, F sharp 7. Now this is bar 5, the G7. Then G minor 7, C7. F sharp B. F B flat. E minor 7. Okay, so I would do that many more times, walking it like a bass person would. But now I'm going to jump and actually running a pattern. So I'm going to run this pattern over the changes. 1-3-5-3. 7-5-3-5. So I'm going to go. I'm going to run that pattern through all the changes, or I'll do the best I can, basically. So this is at 70 on iReal Pro. Here we go. Focused practicing. So what I'm going to focus on, my goal for this is to be able to do what I just did with my eyes closed and have the changes memorized. So I'm going to run through it a bunch of times, and I'm going to start closing my eyes during portions of it to try and force myself to do it from memory. So once again, the pattern I'm doing is 1-3-5-1-3-5-3, ba da da da, and let's see, I got to think about it. 1-3-5-3. Sorry, I'm tired. We had a kind of an emergency here today. All right, so that's the pattern. I'm going to run through the changes. Not bad. I did all that with my eyes closed, so I'm getting to where I have the changes semi-memorized, but what have I really accomplished? And it's, that's always a good thing to ask yourself. I'm practicing. What am I trying to actually get done? So I want to get these changes integrated. So right now my fingers are starting to automatically go to the chord tones, which is great. Now eventually I'm going to introduce different patterns, different rhythms, and more melodic chord leading, voice leading ways of going through the changes. But for right now, I just want to be able to, if somebody called this fast at a jam session, I want to be able to do something to it. So that's 70. I did that fairly well with eyes closed. Let's go up to 80. Same thing. Practice with me. Yeah, no, I want to make sure I'm doing that second change right. C sharp half diminished seventh is C sharp. Yeah, and it's got a G natural. I want to make sure I do that right. Okay, back to the top. Two schools of thought on mistakes. One is you don't make them. You play as slow as you have to play to absolutely play it correctly. The other school is you set a target tempo and you keep working at it no matter what and try to move toward that target tempo. So I've used both approaches. For today, I'm doing the target tempo, trying to gradually get my speed up, and I'm willing to accept a couple mistakes. But bear in mind, I'm setting all these rules myself. I know what I want. I know what I'm trying to do. I know how I'm going to work at getting it. So it's better to do that, I think, than just pick up the horn and go, okay, whatever happens, happens, at least for me. All right, so that was 80, 86 now with the eyes closed. Said also, I practice to correct mistakes, and then right now I'm actually practicing performing. It's not so much, I mean, that makes sense. And in performance mode, you don't stop. It's like you're in front of a real band, and you can't afford to stop and fix something. So that's kind of the way I'm doing it now. All right, let's try 90. I think I had a mental lapse on a couple of those, so we'll try 90. This time, my goal is two times through right before the tempo goes any higher. So if I can't get it absolutely right, I'm not going to move it up. Mistake rule goes down. Okay, I'm going to pull it back down to 80 because that's too many. I had a mental lapse there before the 2-5, so I want to make sure I catch it. Thank you. one time through, right. Okay. So that's the deal. I mean, the essence of great soloing for 3 minutes in reality is the result of maybe 100 hours of practice, you know, as far as stacking things on top of each other. So I'm going to keep working on these changes. Right now I'm getting to where I almost know they're coming. Plus I want them to be inside of me the same way they would be if I was playing piano or playing guitar or bass or one of the harmony instruments. So that's the goal. Anyway, thanks for coming to practice with Kride, Blues for Alice. You guys play and have a great time.